everybody. Just thought I'd give another update here. You know how things are going. Still out here in Texas. Moving a little frac sand. Oh, right now I'm not, but hopefully tomorrow I'll get my drug test back so I can get the stickers put on the truck and get to going. That's been pretty good so far, though. Texas is an interesting place. Kind of like it. People are kind of nice over here. You know, where I'm from, in California, people are fucking rude. But over here, people are pretty nice. You go to the store and everybody's, you know, hi, how you doing? And everybody's seems to be in a decent mood. You go to California, everybody's pissed off. I don't understand why. But yeah, I figured I'd try out this new mount because I got a mount for the window so I can film easier. It's easier than my laptop. But anyways, yeah, I just thought I'd let you know how things are going. And, yeah, I gotta get going here soon because, loads are paying pretty good money right now. So I gotta get a couple in before the end of this pay period so I can make some money. But, yeah, things are going pretty good. Pretty hot over here, though. It's gonna be fun, and you're all decked out, coveralls, and fire-resistant cover, and your respirator and everything else. Yeah. So yeah, this is it, man. This is the truck. Just tinted the windows today. Did kind of a shitty job, but whatever. I don't really care. It keeps the truck cool. Anything to keep this cab cooled off, you know? It's hot. Yeah, so I did another video. I did a video on my computer, but I don't know if I'll use that one because it's kind of fucked up. But my phone's only 17% right now. But I might post this one because it'd probably be easier on my phone. But I know that there was a lot of people that are wanting to do this frac sand or come into the oil fields. Texas or North Dakota or where the fuck ever. It doesn't matter where you go. It's all going to be the same and you're going to need certain shit to haul a frac sand. And you got to be certified in a bunch of different areas. One of them is H2S gas. You got to be certified in that. You got to know about that shit. It's fucking bad. You don't want to be exposed to it or nothing. The other one is all the companies that drill out here, so like Marathon is one of them, and then Ethica or whatever the fuck it's called, I don't know. There's one of them. I got certified in it today. What the fuck was the other one? Oh, it was Marathon I did today. The other one was Freedom or some shit. And you gotta be PEC certified, so you gotta do a PEC class. You gotta know about all that. You gotta have this little guy here, H2S monitor, in order to come out here. I'm not really sure how much they are. Mine was the guy I'm running for, he gave me mine, so it's brand new. Gotta have this shit. Respirator. Just bought this today. It was $100. Bad. Fire resistant, at least coveralls or clothing. Shit's gotta be fire resistant. Hard hat. Rated safety glasses. I think you can have the dark lens or clear, but I have both, so it doesn't matter. They gotta wrap around, you know, they gotta come over here. They gotta be rated. Hard hat, obviously. Steel-toed boots, obviously. Yeah, other than that, seems pretty easy. I was looking at the trailer and everything. My trailer only has one gauge, though, so it only has a tank pressure gauge. And usually the trailers have two pressure gauges. One's a line pressure and one is a tank pressure, so we'll have to see how that is going to work with just having the tank pressure, because you won't know how much... I won't know how much pressure is in them lines that's feeding, you know, all the sand out through the lines, so we'll have to play with it. Hopefully it's not a big deal. Probably just going to have a gauge put on that line, though, so I know the line pressure. I don't think it's too hard. Yeah. Well, I figured I'd just let you guys know what's going on out here. It's a good place to be right now. There's lots of money being made. I think the guy I'm running for, his last paycheck was like $2,700. That was for 1 week. I ain't a bad paycheck for a week, man. And work, like I said, don't seem that hard. I mean, I haven't really done it yet, so I'm not going to, like, I can say that it is or isn't. I mean, but it doesn't seem that way anyways. So, yeah, I have... Definitely, though, I would suggest if you don't have at least a year over-the-road experience, you get that. Because if you only got like 3 months or 4 months experience over the road, then it's probably not going to work out. They're going to want at least a year solid. Or two. I know, I mean, I got like five, so I don't, you know, I was good there. But in the company that I'm running for, your record's got to be pretty clean. I mean, you can get away with some stuff. But you want to make sure that you're up to date on everything, your logs and all that. You're not overrunning yourself or getting a bunch of violations. Because I know that I had a few, and they brought it all up, and they had the whole report out, and they were like, "This is this and that," you know. But it didn't matter because I start fresh with this company, which is cool. But you want to be sure that you don't got too much going on, because they want you to be pretty safe out here. This shit's dangerous. These oil fields ain't nothing to fuck with. I mean, you gotta be pretty on it. And they'll kick your ass off, too. If you fuck around, they'll kick you off. I was just in the office today, and there was a guy that they fucking booted. Because he was just doing stupid shit, you know? So, you gotta watch out. You don't wanna be... I mean, if you wanna get out here and make money, you gotta do it right. Be professional and everything, so... Anyways, yeah. I'm running about 9 minutes on this video, so I'm gonna keep it short. My phone's about to die, and I'll try to get this uploaded so that you guys can see it and everything. Always, if you want to know more, just comment and message me. I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. Right now, I'm pretty much not doing shit. I'm just sitting here, so hopefully in the next couple of days, I'll get going, and I'll pour some more videos and let you know how it's going and what's going on out here. Because I know that I was looking it up before I came out here, and there wasn't too many guys that I was noticing on YouTube that were doing the frac sand. There's one other guy that is doing YouTube videos. He seems pretty cool, so he knows what the fuck he's doing. It'd be cool to run into him out here. So maybe if he checks out my video, we can get in contact or something, have dinner or whatever. Chat it up. Anyways, alright guys, always be safe out there. Keep the dirty side down, the shiny side up, and we'll see you on down the road.